Barrowcliffe now joins me, a super fan of Whitehawk Football Club. I've seen it at the ground myself a few times when I've been doing coverage there. So obviously a disappointing season last season. I heard you shouting and swearing from the stands for the games.
You wouldn't have heard me swearing. we don't swear at Whitehawk.
Don't swear at Whitehawk, of course, yes. So in terms of like pre-season, obviously the friendlies are kicking off. We've just seen the footage from the loss against Hayward Heath the other night. More matches to come. They got relegated last year. What areas of the team have they needed to improve, do you think, to sort of... and what are your expectations for this season coming ahead?
Well, the problem is that at this level, particularly when you get relegated, the whole team goes. So last season, second half of the season, we were actually on form, top five. But we'd had such a bad start to the season that we never really caught that up. But if we'd kept the team that finished last season for this season, we'd romp this division. You know, we had some really, really great players that frankly could have played at a much higher level. They've all gone. Steve King, the manager, has been poached by Welling. He's taken a lot of those players with him. And so the new manager, Jude McDonald, starting with a pretty much a clean slate. So the answer is, I don't know, because I don't know what quality players Jude's going to manage to get in. I know he's a good coach. I've been impressed by what I've seen of him. But again, who knows what he'll attract? The one bright spark is that we've kept Kai Marsh Brown, who's a real quality player, former Arsenal, chose to leave Arsenal of his own free will to get first team football all the time. England C international. And we've kept him on a contract, and he's really, I think he could play at a very high level of football. So he's our winger, very tricky, very good on the ball. And we'll be looking to him to do a lot this season, probably, although you obviously can't just hang it all on one player. He's also got his two brothers with him as well there, have come along. There's Romain, who's come along in defence, who's a pretty experienced pro, so we're pleased to have got him. And his younger brother, who's playing left-back, whether he gets a game or not. So.
But at this level, it's a very different... I mean, there's no transfer window, so they could be buying and loaning players throughout the season.
Yeah, they could be. I don't know. I mean, last season, what happened is we started with a quite tight budget, and then it all went wrong, and the purse string loosened a bit, and we got a few players in that we were hoping were going to get us out of trouble, didn't quite manage it in the end. Theoretically, but I don't know what the benefactors, we don't know whether you call them board, whatever you want to call them, are planning in terms of spending this season.
OK, we're going to wrap it up here, Mark, but very quickly, I've experienced Whitehawk. What would you say to those football fans that, you know, can't get a ticket at the Amex and to come down? Because it's a very, you know, obviously the ultras are well known, it's very politically correct. My favourite song there, The Referee's a Referee, is often sung. Yeah. So why should people come and see Whitehawk?
It's a family club and it tries to make everybody welcome, no matter what your background. So if you find traditional football, sort of the atmosphere at it, you know, very, putting it bluntly, very white, male and aggressive, you'll hopefully find a welcome at Brighton because, at Whitehawk, because we have a policy of being welcome to everyone. One of our songs is Football's for All, and we really mean that. We try to make everybody absolutely welcome. And it's a family club, as I say. I take my kids go free. It's good fun is the main thing. It's a real hoot. I took my lodger down there the other day and he couldn't believe what good fun the whole thing was. It's a hoot is the main thing. That's the main reason you should
go. I'll vouch for that. I've been there a few times. And, you should certainly go down to Whitehawk when you can this season. For now, Mark, thanks for coming and good luck for the forthcoming season.
Thanks so much, Guy.